Guys, I am Yumi, and today I bring you the Lilo and Stitch's house that appears at the end of the movie Lilo and Stitch. Well, actually it's a combination from the first house in which Nani and Lilo's parents lived in, and the one renovated by the whole gang, Lilo, Stitch, Nani, David, Cobra, Yomba, and Pligley. I kept the shape of the last one that appears in Lilo and Stitch 2, and the Disney series, but the furnishing and the floor plan recreates as accurate as possible the first movie for two main reasons. First, we get to see a lot of the house along the movie. We get to see the laundry room when Lilo hides in the washer, Nani's room, the kitchen a couple of times, a lot of the living room, etc, etc. And the second reason, at the end of the movie, we see a tower that might be on the third or fourth floor. I truly believe it's just one floor difference, so that would be like third one. But to make it look taller from the outside, I placed it on the fourth one. And since we don't have cylindrical stairs or elevators, I don't know if they are available with other expansion packs, and foundations are not as freely to use as I wish, I left the tower as simple decoration. In other words, there is nothing inside of it. Though when I finished the video, I thought that I could have accessed it by using cheats and teleporting, but it was too late when I realized that. But the house is so expensive that I'm glad it didn't occur to me before. Talking about expensive prices, this lot costs about 112,665 simoleons. I know it's expensive, and I mean expensive, but I didn't add much more of what I get to see in the movie, aside from some decorations. But considering that it is supposed to be a small house, I am surprised, because I thought it was going to be cheaper and smaller. But it was so expensive even before I did landscaping that I couldn't fix that at all. I saw the movie and some scenes again and again to try to make it a replica. Like, I counted the squares of the grid that I was planning to use, I freezed the movie and took notes, but sometimes it didn't make sense, and that's why it looks bigger. And it is. Still, I believe it turned out very nicely, and we ended with two rooms, two bedrooms, a kind of a studio which is only a bookshelf at the end of the hall for your Sims to use, and because I didn't know what else to add there. The living room, the kitchen, the laundry room, and I guess that's pretty much it. As luck traits for this house, we have science lair thanks to Jumba, volcanic activity, and great acoustics in honor to Elvis and the movie Marvelous soundtrack. Fact! Actually, Lilo and Stitch have the record for the movie with most Elvis Presley songs on it, and in this video I included some of those, such as Heartbreak Hotel, Hound Dog, Suspicious Minds, Stalking You, and of course at the very end, Burning Love, just like in the movie. So if you really like those, you should see the whole video or just jump to the last 3 minutes, cause I won't be talking there. If I'm honest, I wish YouTube had like a 2 audio track, so if you wanted to only hear the music, you could mute the talkative person, in this case me. But if you want to do that, I leave in the description of this video link to YouTube to a list of the original soundtrack for you to enjoy. But never mind, can I say that I loved how the roof came out? I am so proud of myself at this point, but let's see. This house have 4 floors, only 1.5 available to actually play in the game. But anyways, in the first floor, we can find a car. Remember, we finally have non-functional cars in The Sims 4 with the debug menu, thanks to the last update. But I didn't find them, so it's just a big toy that I added to get in the mood and to complete the reference that's right now on screen. Then, on the left side, it's a kind of garden. It is not supposed to be part of the house, but do you remember the hammock scene when Nani sings to Lilo? I love that so much. I wanted to include it, but we don't have hammocks, so I built a hill and placed 2 loungers as a reference for that place. In the second floor, we have the living room, the kitchen, the laundry room, a bathroom, and Nani's bedroom. How often can you say room in a sentence? Which originally was her mother's and father's, because she shared with Lilo. We can see like a top on the bed. Remember, these are my personal assumptions. So that's what I believe. And in the third floor, there is Lilo's room and bathroom. The rest of it is just the structure. I struggled a little bit while choosing the roof color and material. I didn't want it to be kind of old or dirty, but it was the only orange one. Also, I must say I cut some of the process, just like choosing the roof, building the hill, placing more than 3 times the same stairs because it was too long. And with the purpose to make this video shorter, I didn't include the bathrooms, and they are not official. We never see those in the movies, so they are completely irrelevant. But I included them in the final screenshots, so you can have a quick look to them. Now, we are moving on to the furnishing. Okay, I used the Island Living expansion pack, the Parenthood content pack again, but this time I swear I used it correctly. And the difference between this video and the last one is the laundry accessories pack. I literally bought it just for this video. I hope I'll have the chance to use it again in the future, which I believe it's going to happen because, like, real houses do have washer and dry machine, right? So, let's get started with the living room. First of all, when choosing the door, I was so insecure with the first one. I mean, it was reddish, kind of orange, but I didn't like it until I discovered this amazing door that came with the laundry pack. I mean, it has the curtain that I needed. And even if it didn't came with the color, it is perfect. It fits. It's amazing. Not to mention the song that we are listening right now. I literally put it there because it represents the first time we get to see the house in and out. Now, in here, we have access to the hall and the kitchen. No doors for that, a couple of sofas, some tables, like the one in the middle of the room. If you look at some official art, you will see that they place it to put popcorn or food and stuff when having the whole gang in the house, to see movies or whatever. When we have a small TV and a gramophone, yes, we have a gramophone. I am just so amazed about how EA people include these kind of items. I really love it, and it's available with the base game, so what could be better than this? There is another version of it in Get Famous expansion pack, but it's not like Lilo's one. I am aware that maybe somewhere out there, you should be able to find CC custom content to have a more accurate replica, but the point of my video is to build for you without using CC, so you can download it from the gallery, and I really hope you enjoy both the building and the video. Now, in the kitchen, we will find the cupboard. I never heard of that word before. I use Google Translator, but it's like a little room where you keep food, right? The dining table, a couple of chairs, a stove, fridge, and a table with some school projects that came with Parenthood. I placed the Fetish Volcano Science project to add a narrative touch. So let's imagine that actually mom and dad helped Nanny and Lilo with their school projects. On the other hand, I didn't add that messy kitchen that we always get to see in the movie because I wanted to have functional items and countertops. But can we talk about that they have the stuff next to the fridge? That's so insecure. I mean, it literally gives you a context of a chaotic life, though I don't think Nanny moved the stove. So why would you put the stove next to the fridge in the first place? I don't understand that. Anyways, if you want to play with your Sims in this house, I didn't add anything from cats and dogs. First, I didn't want to add another expansion pack because I want these to be accessible for a lot of people. Second, Stitch never uses pet stuff. We never see him eating dog food. I mean, he gets coffee. So if you want to play with Stitch, you can have a blue toddler. I know it's weird, but he's like a kid, you know? Or you can have cats and dogs, and you can totally add a pet and place whatever your pet will need. I changed the place of some items as usual. I checked everything was functional. Every toilet, every chair, everything. So for example, the coffee maker is now on the other countertop. so you have nothing to worry about. Curious fact, Lilo and Stitch was released in 2002 and used a watercolor technique for the backgrounds that was used 60 years before in 1941 when the 2D animated Dumbo came out. Back to the living room, in all of the versions of Lilo and Stitch, and I'm referring to the second movie in series, we have a bookshelf next to the door. And now that I think about it, I forgot to add the rug that's supposed to be in the front door, but I will fix that before uploading the build to the gallery. As an activity or skill for your sim to develop, I added a guitar. You just have to imagine it's a ukulele. And then in the laundry room, you will find a work table to do carpentry, and it's shown in the movie with tools and accessories. Now, the frame that's on the living room, it is supposed to be a boat, but I couldn't find one, so if you activate the cheats with testing cheats on, and then you use bb.showhiddenobjects and bb.ignoregameplayunlocksentitlement, you will have access to these photographs that I added, and I added some of them in the hall. Actually, you can unlock them with the diver profession or the conservationist one. So, also, narrative thing, let's think about that mom or dad were conservationists, or maybe both, which reminds me of, at some point in the last year or so, Paul Briggs, who is a storyboard artist, visual effects animator, and a voice actor, worked in the movie, post an official image in Twitter of a 22-year-old Lilo and said, "Prop studying marine biology," and confirmed she have a niece and hosts a radio show called Hail to the King, which is an Elvis tribute show that she broadcasts into deep space. Cool, huh? I will leave a link to it in the description below, so check it out. Now we arrive to the laundry room, and it counts with a washer and drying machine, the carpenter table, some decoration, and almost everything from laundry day. The structure of the room is a little bit different from the movie, so the carpenter table should be next to the door, but then the room would have ended way bigger, or I would have had to move the door, and then I wouldn't match the kitchen and trays alignment, because they kind of make a hole or something like that. Still, I added some dirty clothes in the floor. I was looking for a mop and a broom from the debug menu, but I couldn't find them. I know we have a broom as a wall decoration, but I am also aware that there is another one that you can lie on the floor. Anyways, I kept adding some laundry, but the first time you use the washing machine, which I didn't test it, your sim will automatically start picking up some of those and add them to the washer. Very smart. And the last item I placed is something from the debug menu and tries to simulate the gas tank since we don't have any. Now, if you listen closely, you will hear Aloha Oe, which is Nani's song, and it means we are in Nani's bedroom. It took me a couple of Google image research to figure it out if the bed was in the same wall side as the door, or if it was on the next wall. Everything because there's a curtain next to her bed, and that's a big mistake from my part because the curtain probably was a decoration from the entrance to the bathroom, because I still believe this room was the master bedroom, or to a wardrobe. I could have mirrored the room, but I wanted to look like in the movie. Now that I think about it, I can change the bathroom and place it where the bathroom is, and vice versa. Okay, I will try to do this before uploading this to the gallery. I am so excited, it took me 2 days to discover that, or to figure it out how to put that. But anyways, going back. The movie poster I added was the closest I found to Mulan, since it's a girl on a llama, like, you know, Mulan and her horse. Well, I tried, guys. Also, I wanted to include some medals, but instead we got a Parenthood item with stickers, because we don't have wall medals. But don't worry, I did added the trophies, though they are not surf trophies, but it would be like very hard to have trophies about everything, right? So I want to emphasize that Nani was a surfing winner, and because of the accident and the loss of her parents, which is really sad, she just had to quit, get different jobs, and take care of her little sister, which eventually turned out to be her sister, three aliens, not to talk about the other 625 experiments or Stitch cousins, and once in a while a social worker. I can say her life is full of action and there is no time to get bored anymore. In here, I try different displays for the trophies which are similarly related to exercise or the sports career. I thought of placing them on the bookshelf, but at the end I went for two displays and also used the side table for the big one. So this cake decoration, like I just imagine it's sort of the creation, could match the way I organized the wall. I did include a speaker on the chair. I wanted also to place like dirty clothes in there, but maybe it was too much. At the end of this, I just added a couple of plants, a big flowers rock, the curtain, and the hairdryer that's mentioned on Little One Stitch 2 when Nanny is looking for it. And then it brings us to one of the funniest moments in the movie when Lilo and Stitch are fighting and they're arguing about if Lilo is touching or not Stitch, which I found very hilarious. And once we finish this room, we will go upstairs, add the lighting, and we will get into Lilo's room. I want to mention that I added two bedrooms for the house so I could fill the empty space, and last but not least, because we had four people living in this house and probably just one bedroom was not enough to cover basic necessities. But we are heading off the topic. I placed some toys and disaster in Lilo's bedroom, added a kid door. Different foundations didn't work aside from the first floor, I guess. So I couldn't add like little pallet where she kept the painting thing. But I did keep the basics for the room, such as toys, a bookshelf, the window, and added a craft table, which is for kids to do some arts and doodles. The soundtrack for this room, I chose the song when Stitch is trying to get used to the room. Of course, I added pictures in the walls next to the bed. I did edit this room a little bit to make it messier. And we are heading to the landscaping, which means my talkative part is over. If you watched the video until this point, thank you very much. I really appreciate it. I hope you liked it. And if you do so, please leave a comment. Remember, I left a couple of links in the below in the description, Twitter and soundtrack. The lot will be available in the gallery under the name of Lilo and Stitch or with my ID Yumi Agatsuma. Please don't forget to turn on the BB.move objects on cheat before placing it. Enjoy Suspicious Minds and Burning Love, and if things turn out according to plan, I will see you in the future. Bye!
Want to listen to the king? You look like an Elvis fan.
We're caught in a trap. I can't walk out because I love you too much, baby. Why can't you see what you're doing to me? When you don't believe a word I say, we can't go on together with suspicious. Thank you.
let's move on to step two. Elvis played guitar. Here, hold it like this and put your fingers here. See? Now you try.
My chest is just a heathen. Love.